Good morning. Welcome again to our service this Sunday, the 2nd of May, here at St. Leonard's Church. Let's begin and continue as we do with the words. Please respond with the words in bold as they appear on the screen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore celebrate by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins, and confess to you our weakness and unbelief. We have lived by our own strength and not by the power of your resurrection. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived by the light of our own eyes, as faithless and not believing. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived for this world alone and doubted our home in heaven. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, we're going to listen to our first song, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Jesus Christ is now alive.
Hello, my name is Elena, and welcome to my living room. We're going to sing a song together, and it's called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Jesus Christ is now alive. I think that you'll know the tune, so you should be able to sing along, but it would be good if you could do some actions as well. Now, I can't really do actions and play guitar at the same time. What can we do about this? That's better. So follow me for the singing and follow me for the actions. Great, let's go.
I'm sure we'll be doing that just as fast when we're allowed to sing again in here, so try and remember those words. Let us continue in prayer with the collect for this Sunday. Almighty God, who through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, has overcome death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that as by your grace going before us, you put into our minds good desires, so by your continual help, we may bring them to good effect. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And if you please stand for our gospel reading this morning.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Our reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, beginning to read at verse 44. He said to them, "This is what I told you while I was still here with you. Everything must be fulfilled that is written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms." Then he opened their minds so they could understand the scriptures. He told them, "This is what is written. The Messiah will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. I am going to send you what my Father has promised, but stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Please do be seated. Today is Sunday, the 2nd of May, and this evening I plan to relax with my wife Laura in front of the television. This is because, like a lot of people, I'm eagerly awaiting the final episode of Line of Duty, which is on this evening. Like every good TV program, every episode of Line of Duty ends with that desperate and burning question: what happens next? Every time you find out one piece of information, you know there are more questions that need answering. And you know the next episode will at least hopefully answer them. What happens next is the same question that makes it hard to put down that book that you're into. What happens next is the question in your mind when your football team kicks the restart during the game, or when your eyes are fixed on something interesting happening, or a disagreement at school, work, or elsewhere. What happens next? It's the question that keeps us engaged in what we see or do, and it makes us want to be part of it. Today, we're very almost at the end of Luke's gospel account. What happens next is the question to take us through this passage. It's late on Easter Sunday evening. Jesus has been seen, risen from the dead by a number of disciples, and has just appeared among many more of them in a locked room. Well, last week, Mark explained to us more from verses 36 to 43, that wonderful reminder that Christ's wounds on the cross remain even in his resurrection body, the wounds that bring about our healing. Having shown himself to his disciples, what happens next? Our passage today begins as Jesus points his disciples to the scriptures, reminding them that everything which has happened to him is a fulfillment of what the Old Testament teaches. And Jesus opens their minds to understand it. Verses 46 and 47 of our passage, they carry the weight of the text today. In them we have a refined version of Jesus' explanation of the Old Testament to his disciples. And we'll look at it in the three main words in it. On the screen, we turn to the NRSV version, where these words can be seen more clearly concerning the Messiah: to suffer, to rise, and to be proclaimed. Well, firstly, Jesus had to suffer. This was anticipated by the Old Testament, and Jesus had predicted this throughout his ministry. This suffering, his most horrific death on the cross, is what has paid the price for us, taking the punishment for our wrongdoings. We've explicitly looked at this over the past few weeks, and Jesus had made it clear to his disciples again and again that his atoning and substitutionary death are essential to our salvation. The Old Testament scripture said that the Christ will suffer. But what happened next? Jesus had to be raised. Again, this was evident in the scriptures and spoken of so many times by Jesus before it happened. Jesus was the first to be truly resurrected from the dead into his glorious resurrection body. His resurrection allows for our resurrection. While his death took away the punishment for our sin, if he'd stayed dead, then death would have had the final victory. But because he was raised, we will be. More than just our sins taken away, resurrection awaits us. His resurrection means his righteousness is put on us. His resurrection is just as essential to our salvation as his death. The Old Testament scripture said the Christ would rise. But what happens next? This is what remains to be accomplished. There are five key elements that dominate this mission statement to be proclaimed. The first, the disciples are called to preach, which we see beginning in Acts chapter 2. The church has been proclaiming Jesus through the preached word ever since. The gospel of Jesus is supposed to be preached. And Jesus is right to remind us that this is how the kingdom grows. Their message is a call to repentance. More than just saying sorry, it's a concept of turning around. We need a relationship with God and a call to turn to him in faith. Turn away from our sins. If we come to the Father, we need an awareness that the direction we were traveling in was the wrong one. It's clear from our passage that in spite of what you may have heard elsewhere, there is such thing as right and wrong. Some things are right and some things are simply wrong. The wrong is what we call sin, and it's what God defines it as. Thirdly, what is being offered is forgiveness of sins. It doesn't need to be any obstacle between people and God anymore. As we turned to God through Jesus, the offer of forgiveness becomes real in God's willingness to be gracious and cancel the debt of sin that Jesus paid for us. The authority of all of this is in the name of Jesus. The kingliness of Jesus is inescapable. And as the reason that Jesus is Lord and Christ is himself, he's the one who carries out the forgiveness of his people, as well as healings and baptisms, and we read many of them later in the book of Acts. And the message itself, number five, it is for all nations. But preaching will start in Jerusalem. This was never a message nor a salvation just for the Jewish people or those living in Jerusalem at that time. But neither is it simply reserved for a certain amount of the British population in the 21st century, those living in Padiham Parish. I know that a great many of you regularly pray for Alan and Debbie Burt, our mission partners in South Africa that we sponsor. Do you also know that many countries around the world actually send their mission partners here to us in the United Kingdom? Some of you may remember Stephen Adesanya, until recently the vicar in Briarfield. He came here from Nigeria. And there are many such other people in this country and around the world who have taken to heart the all nations call of this gospel message, taking it far and wide. And what happens next? What happens next is this is still what remains to be accomplished. Repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in Jesus' name to all nations. This too is an essential part of God's salvation plan. It always was. Although I'm sure some of you are wondering, I'm not sure what this has got to do with me. I'm not a preacher, I'm not gifted in that way. Well, that's fair enough. Though I have no doubt that the disciples Jesus was speaking to at the time thought exactly the same. Not gifted public speakers, not well educated, lacking that certain refinement or the right accent from their country. So let's look at Jesus' answer to them in the final verse. I am going to send you what my Father has promised, but stay in the city until you've been clothed with power from on high. Like those disciples, we're not called to do anything in our own strength, but in the power from on high that God has clothed us with, the Holy Spirit. As Christians and disciples of Jesus, the joy of sharing the good news of his gospel is actually with all of us. What is more, the power of the Holy Spirit lives in all of us as well. The Holy Spirit isn't just for a select few. It's for all God's people. And so we're reminded again, we're not doing this in our own strength. What happens next? Jesus suffered and died. After that, Jesus was raised from the dead. And after that, Jesus will be proclaimed to all nations. This third phase is the one we are in now. The good news of Jesus has been shared all around the world, but it still needs to be shared even more and right here in this parish. What happens next is that we are called to be part of this proclamation, to share with those near as well as far, repentance for the forgiveness of sins, those whom you love and know, those at work, those your next door neighbours, your family members, your children, if they're small, discipling them as Christians, if they're older and grown up, still being their parents and sharing with them the good news of Jesus. This final stage, proclaiming it, it's where we're at, and the call to do so isn't just for a select few, but all of us, the capability to share with others these truths. Repentance for the forgiveness of Jesus, for the forgiveness of sins in the name of Jesus to all nations. If you can't go far with this message, then share it with those who are near. We're going to listen to our next song now. Facing a task unfinished.
Facing a task unfinished that drives us to our knees. A need that undiminished rebukes our slothful ease. We who rejoice to know thee renew before thy throne the solemn pledge we owe thee to go and make thee known.
Can I ask you all to stand at this point, please? If you're someone who's a little unsure as to what the truths of the gospel that we share are, we're going to affirm them together now in the words of the creed. If you can please respond with the words in bold. If we could have the words on the screen, please. Thank you. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father. Begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. And his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please sit or kneel as we pray together.
Let us pray to the Father who hears us. Father in heaven, thank you for gathering us together today. Thank you for making us a family, brothers and sisters, joined with our brother, our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for making us into a people who worship you and for equipping us with your Holy Spirit to know you. We love you so much, and we greatly appreciate the great gift of who you are. Lord, may we prize how great that gift is. How great is the gift of yourself in us, now and forever. Thank you, Lord, for teaching us of yourself, beginning with Moses and the prophets, for they speak of you. You opened the understanding of the men walking with you on the road to Emmaus. They marveled at how the scriptures reveal you and how you were to come, suffer, and claim victory through resurrection. Now, Lord, open our understanding each and every time we explain the scriptures to each other. Let us discover throughout your word you. For we know that every page, old and new, is always about you. May we grow in knowing you, that we may be filled with the knowledge of your will and all spiritual wisdom and understanding. We ask that we desire earnestly to grow in that understanding to the glory of your kingdom. Whatever we do, may it be to the glory of you, Lord. Please, Lord, use us equipped to image you to the world, the whole world, to all nations, holding firm to what we were taught from the beginning. Let us accept no other gospel save salvation through you. To the one true gospel of Jesus, we witness to all. Lord, thank you for those you appointed to serve as ministers. We lift up Mark, Kit, our wardens, our bishops, Julian and Philip. We lift them up before you, that you fill them with wisdom and strength. May those who lead have your mind in all things pertaining to the good governance of your body. Lord, we ask you to bless our national leaders. May they uphold our heritage as a country with a church at its heart. May we, as a nation, this week, choose wisely those who will be appointed to order our common good. We commit them to all that honors your lordship over us. Lord, we lift up our queen and her family. Thank you for your wisdom that you first placed in her beginning long ago, and which continues to shine. Strengthen her to carry huge responsibilities as our sovereign, and may she continue to reign over us. We intercede for those among us who are sick, Gwen Todd, Jackie Lowry, and Noah Pickard, and for the family of Geraldine Plevin in their bereavement. Lord, we count everything as loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus, our Lord. We cast aside what hinders in order that we may gain you. We desire to be in you with your righteousness, that we may know you in the power of your resurrection, becoming more and more like you. Amen.
Before we come to gather around the Lord's table, just notices. There's just one quick notice this morning, which is that the church magazine for May remains available in the foyer at the back. As we prepare to come around the Lord's table, let us listen to the hymn together, O Church, Arise. Ask you to please stand. This is what is written. The Messiah is to suffer, and from the dead to rise on the third day, and repentance for the forgiveness of sins is to be preached in his name to all nations. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. All glory and honor be yours always and everywhere. Mighty Creator, ever-living God, we give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. By his death on the cross, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. And now we give you thanks that you raised him to life triumphant and exalted him in glory. By his victory over death, the reign of sin is ended. A new day has dawned. A broken world is restored, and we are made whole once again. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hear us, merciful Father, we humbly pray, and grant that we, receiving these gifts of your creation, this bread and this wine, according to your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Amen. Please do be seated. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you, preserve your bodies and souls to everlasting life. Take and eat, in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith and with thanksgiving. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Eternal God, whose Son Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life, grant us to walk in his way, to rejoice in his truth, and to share his risen life, who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace, to love and to serve the Lord, in the name of Christ. Amen.